Good afternoon, Vandan. Today we are going to discuss briefly about LTI systems, linear time invariant systems. We have discussed about linear systems and time invariant systems in the last class, right? What is a linear system? Linear system, for example, x1 of n is the input and the concerned output of the system is y1 of n. x2 of n is the input and the concerned output is y2 of n. If that is a linear system, then what should be the output for this? Yeah, I can try to respond. What is the output of this for a linear system? See, this should be a into y1 of n plus b into y2 of n, right? Superposition principle should be satisfied. When a and b are some real constants, should be satisfied. Then you can call it a linear system. And the generalized version of this is, if the input to the system is sigma k ak into xk of n, then the concerned output should be sigma k ak yk of n, where yk of n corresponds to output when the input is xk of n. Then you can call it as a linear system. And time invariant system, for time invariance, suppose input is x of n and the output is y of n. If the input got delayed by some k samples where k is integer, then the output also should be delayed by k samples. Same output we are getting, but after k units delay, k samples delay. The time invariant system. LTI system means that should satisfy linearity and time invariance properties. That should be linear and time invariant system. Then you can call it as LTI system, linear time invariant system. For example, if this is the input to my system, and the output of the system is represented by hk of n. Yeah, can you just speak out what can be the output notation for this delta of n minus 1? Yeah, you should speak. When the input is delta of n minus k, the output we are going to get is represented by hk of n. When the input is delta of n minus 1, then what is the output? Yeah, can you speak once? Yeah. What is the output? H1 of n, right? Yeah. Output is H1 of n. Similarly, when the input is delta of n, the output we are going to represent with H0 of n. When the input is delta of n plus 3, the output we are representing with h minus 3 of n is output. They are just notations. Let us say that when this is the input to the system, input to that discrete time system, this is the output we are going to get from the system. They are just notations that we are going to follow now. And let me say that is LTI system, linear and time invariant system. Can someone answer what can be the output of this system? Sigma k x of k into delta of n minus k. Can someone speak out what is the output of this one? You can apply linearity property. If you want, you can apply linearity property. Because this is linear and time invariant system, you can go for linearity property of that one. If that is a linear system, you can have a look into this, right? For a linear system, this will be satisfied. And the input is sigma k ak xk of n. The output we are going to get is sigma k ak and the corresponding responses. This is response or output for xk of n. This is the response or output for xk of n, right? And this remains as it is. Linear combination. Due to linearity property, you can try to do something like that, right? This is something similar to your AK. Some constant for the given K is something like AK. You can imagine like that one. And what is the response we are going to get for delta of n minus K? The response for delta of n minus K is HK of n, right? This is the response or the output we are going to get for that. And if you apply linearity property, then we are going to get the constant output as follows. The constant remains same. And the response of this one is hk of n, right? According to our notation. This is not only linear, this is time invariant also. Time invariant means, for example, if I try to call h naught of n with h of n, I want to follow this notation. I want to say, I want to represent my h naught of n like h of n. Some notation change, that's it. What actually h naught of n means? Yeah, can someone answer? According to our notation, what is h naught of n? It's a response for which input?
Delta of n.
Delta of n, right? Is the output of the system when the input is delta of n, right? We are trying to rename this with h of n. The response we are going to get for the input delta of n. This is called as impulse response, right? Impulse response means the response or the output we are going to get when the given input is impulse. The impulse sample, right? And the given input is impulse sample, the corresponding response is known as impulse response. Yeah, if you want to have that symbolic notation for that, this is our system, our transformation. And the output we are going to get is known as impulse response for this system. If I follow this notation, then what should be the output for delta of n minus k? If you apply time invariance property, for delta of n, we are calling it as h of n. Then what should be the output when the input is delayed by k samples? Yeah, what is the output? Apply time invariance property.
H of n minus k.
H of n minus k, right? Yeah, it's fine. Output also delayed by k sample, right? When you delay the input by k samples, output also delayed by k samples. Delta of n minus k. Now we can simply apply this into this expression. We can replace hk of n with h of n minus k, right? We can try to replace hk of n with h of n minus k. Due to time invariance property. We consider the system as LTA system, linear time invariant system. That's why you can go with this, right? There is no issue with that. It means finally we are going to end up with this. This is my input, k equals minus infinity to plus infinity. The output I am going to get is sigma k equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. Due to linearity property, I am able to write up to this. This constant in hk of n, right? Now, due to time invariance property, I am replacing this with h of n minus k. I replace this with h of n minus k. This kind of thing you might have seen in signals and systems course. Yeah. What is the name of this? What is the name of this operation? Is there any specific name for this? See, our input x of n, we are having like this, sigma k goes to minus infinity to plus infinity. X of k input, right? Delta of n minus k. The graphical representation of this one is as follows. The graphical representation of this sequence x of n. See, n versus x of n. Let me have index 0, index 1, and index 2, index 3, for example. Some random sequence I am considering. See, 4, index 5, and so on. Similarly, this side. Let me have index minus 1, and index minus 2, and so on. Integer indices. Then, what is the symbolic representation of this one? Yeah, what is the symbolic representation for this? X of 0, right? You see, n versus x of n. You see, x of 0 into delta of n. Then, what is the symbolic representation for this? Yeah, I can speak out, right?
X of 1 into delta 1.
Yeah, delta of n minus 1.
Minus 1.
And this one corresponds to, yeah, if you want, you can remove this. There is no issue with that one. While writing mathematically, you can have that one. You see, x of 2 into delta of n minus 2. This will be x of 3 into delta of n minus 3. And this will be x of minus 1 into delta of n plus 1, x of minus 2 into delta of n plus 2. This is a representation of that one, graphical representation of this signal. This is my input sequence x of n. This is my input sequence. And the output from my LTA system is as follows. This is the output I am going to get. When I consider LTA system with an impulse response h of n. This is linear time invariant system with impulse response. H of n. X of n gets linearly convolved with impulse response H of n. This is the output we are going to get when that is LTA system, linear time invariant system. Okay, now I'll try to ask you a question. Suppose, let me consider some system. It's some digital system or discrete system. If I gave you input x of n, and if I give impulse response t of delta of n equals to h of n. This is the impulse response of the system. If I give this thing to you, can you find the output y of n? Is it possible to find the output if you know the impulse response? Is it possible or not possible? Just consider this one. Forget about the discussion till now. Is it possible? Yeah, based on your signals and systems background, can you try that? Is it possible to find the output? You should speak out, right?
Yes, sir.
No, someone sent it. Sai Prasad. Yeah, can you speak?
Yes, sir.
How to find? No, how can you find? I feel you can't find. There is a constraint, right? You should not forget about this. That should be LTI system. If I say that is linear time invariant system, then you can find. If it is linear time invariant system, then it's possible. You can find. There is no doubt at all. The response you can find as linear convolution of the input x of n with h of n is a linear convolution. Where that linear convolution is nothing but this one. This is a linear convolution. If you know h of n, you can simply go for shifted version of that, right? Shifted by k samples, and after that doing some mathematical operations. You can guess what can be your output response without doing the experiment also. Mathematically, you can compute that, right? Once you know the impulse response, you can try to find the output mathematically without doing any experiment, right? Just by doing convolution with input signal x of n is the output we are going to get. In that way, you can do. But there should be LTI system. If this is not an LTI system, it's not possible, right? If you want to do convolution with impulse response, there should be an LTI system. Then only is this a valid one. You should make sure that there should be LTI system. It means if you know the impulse response of an LTI system, we can compute the output sequence for any given input sequence by convolving x of n with h of n. It means impulse response of an LTI system completely characterizes the system. If you know impulse response of LTI system, you can do anything, right? You can find the output for the given input. That input x of n can be anything. At least you can compute mathematically, right? That output as a linear convolution with the h of n. And let us have a look into some of the interesting things. Y of n minus n naught equal to x of n convolution with h of n minus n naught. Just go to this. Consider LTI system with impulse response h of n. Impulse response h of n. Now, y of n equals to input sequence convolution, linear convolution with h of n. And one of the interesting results you need to remember is we have n minus n naught equals to x of n convolution with h of n minus n naught, or you can have like this also x of n minus n naught convolution with h of n. Both of them are true. If you delay the impulse response of the system by impulse response of the LTI system by n naught samples, the output also got delayed by n naught samples. Otherwise, if you delay the input sequence by n naught samples is nothing but n naught TS, where TS is the sampling period, right? That much time duration. You can have intuitive feeling like that. Delay by n naught samples, then the output also will be delayed by n-odd samples. Is that the LTA system? Either you can have, right? And can you guess? Can you guess something about this? X of n minus n naught convolution with h of n minus n naught. Yeah. What should your guess? What will be this? Y of n minus? How much?
2n naught, sir.
2n naught, right? This should be 2n naught. This will be 2n naught. Minus n naught, minus n naught. This will be 2n naught. This part. This is n naught only. If we have one more thing, minus n naught here, minus n naught here, that will be minus 2n naught. Here are some of the important results. This is basic proof for that. Let us have some interpretation of y of n as a superposition of individual sample responses. We want to have some interpretation about this linear convolution, that x of n convolution with h of n is there, right? Let us have a graphical view of that one once, so that you can understand in better way. If h of n is the impulse response of an LTA system, and this is the input sequence, x of n equal to sigma k x of k into delta of n minus k, then what should be the constant output? This is an LTA system. Yeah. Can someone answer what is the constant output? You can speak out, right?
X of n, sir.
Output. This is input x of n. Output should be?
It's also x of n.
No.
Sir, x of k. Convolution with delta of n.
Convolution with h of n, right? There should be convolution with h of n. And we are going to get sigma k x of k into h of n minus k. This will be h of n minus k. Because delta of n output is h of n. Output of delta of n minus k is h of n minus k, according to our time invariance property. This is the output sequence. Sigma k x of k into h of n minus k. Interpretation of this one. One of the interpretations for this convolution sum. Input sample at n equal to k is x of k into delta of n minus k. That is transformed by the system into an output sequence x of k into h of n minus k for all n. Then for each k, these output sequences are superimposed to form overall output sequence by of n. Yeah, this is as follows. Let me go with some example so that you can understand well. X of n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of k delta of n minus k implies if that is LTA system with impulse response h of n, then this is the output we are going to get, output sequence. Just for our understanding, let me go with some basic example. One, two, and minus one. Let me have this 0, 1, 2, and all others are zeros. 3, 4 at indices, all other indices, this function is zero, x of n. Can someone try to express this in the form of this expression? Yeah, what is x of n according to this? I'll give a hint. 1 into delta of n plus, yeah, what is this?
2 into delta of n minus 1.
Yes, 2 into delta of n minus 1 plus minus 1, right? That should be minus. Yeah. Minus 1 into delta of n minus 2. This is my input, x of n. Now I want to find the constant output. Due to LTI system, linearity property and time invariance property, we know the response for delta of n is h of n, right? Response for this one is, due to linearity and time invariance property, you can have this one. Due to linearity, 1 into delta of n, output will be 1 into h of n. Due to time invariance property, the output of delta of n minus 1 is h of n minus 1. Due to linearity, if you do 2 into something, you are going to get 2 into that one, right? 2 into h of n minus 1. The response for this one will be minus h of n minus 2, right? Minus h of n minus 2. It means what we are going to do here is h of n plus 2 into h of n minus 1, h of n minus 1 plus minus h of n minus 2. Where h of n corresponds to response to this input. And 2 into h of n minus 1 corresponds to response to this input. And minus h of n minus 2 corresponds to response to this input. When this is the input, this is the response we are going to get. Response or output we are going to get. And after that, we are clubbing all together, right? We are trying to add all those responses by applying linearity property, because this is LTI system, linear and time invariant. That's what I had done here. Due to linearity property, you can have something like this, right? For example, impulse response we are having is, this is an impulse response. Let me consider this. Say 1, this is 2. This is 0, this is 1. And all others are zeros. Just for example purpose, minus 1, minus 2, in all other locations, this is 0. 2, 3, all other locations, this is 0. 0, that's fine. See my h of n, impulse response. When the input is delta of n, this is the output I'm going to get. Now, according to this, I'll try to add this one, this sequence with this sequence. 2 into h of n minus 1. Can someone tell me, yeah, where I am to have sample?
2 at 1.
At 1, right? Okay, 2 into 1. This will be 2, right? At 1, okay. And 2 into h of n minus 1 means, h of n minus 1 means this will be shifted. This will be shifted to 1, this will be shifted to 2. After that, we are multiplying with 2. Then this will be 2 and this will be 4, right? Let me have some other color. 1 and 2. At this location, into 2 we are going. 2 and 2 into 2, 4. Like that we can have. Plus minus h of n minus 2. H of n minus 2 means, okay, minus, right? H of n minus 2 means this will be shifted right side by 2 units. 0 will be shifted to 2, 1 will be shifted to 3, right? H of n minus 2 means. After that, multiplication with minus 1. This 1 will become like minus 1. 2 will become like minus 1. At index 2, I'm going to have minus 1. At index 3, I'm going to have minus 2. Minus 2. Now, I need to add all the three responses, individual responses. That's what I need to do, right? Yes, what is the final response we are going to get? Yeah, can someone answer at least the non-zero terms? If you add all the three graphs together, at index 0,
1.
Let me erase this to avoid confusions. Yeah. At index 0, I have 1 plus 0, right? At index 0, I have 0. Let me have indices for this. This is index 1, index 0, index minus 1, like that. Similarly, index 3, 4, and so on. This is 4, like that. All are zeros. At index 0, 1 plus 0 plus 0. This will be 1 at index 0. And at index 1, 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 0, right? At index 1, I have 0. 4, this will be 4. And at index 2, 0 plus 4 plus minus 1. 4 minus 1 means 3, right? At index 2, yeah. At index 3, 0 plus 0 plus minus 2. Minus 2, right? At index 3, I have minus 2. What about index 4?
0, sir.
0, right? All others are zeros. Can you have a look into this? All others are zeros. Similarly, all others are zeros. This is my final outcome, y of n. In this case, convolution of x of n with h of n. This is one view of linear convolution sum. What I had done is, I found response for each of these components separately. This response separately, this response separately, and this response separately. Finally, I added all of them. Due to linearity property, I can add them, right? I had an addition of all those graphs together. From this, let me have this like n. The y coordinate is y of n. It means y of 0 equals to 1. This is at n equal to 0, right? And this is equals to y of 1. This is equals to y of 2. And this is equals to y of 3. If I want, I can write this mathematically as follows. You can have a look into this. 1 into delta of n. Plus 4 into delta of n minus 1. Next, plus 3 into delta of n minus 2. Minus 2 into delta of n minus 3. Mathematically, I can try to write this. Response I am going to get in my final output. Okay, just for our convenience, let me introduce this notation also. Input sequence can be represented like this also. X of n. These are the standard notations in our course. Which are non-zeros in this? This is x happen, right? Non-zeros are at indices 0, 1, 2. Remaining everyone are zeros, right? I'll try to focus on only non-zero interval. At least some of them should be non-zero. You can have a look into this. 1, 2, minus 1. 1, 2, minus 1, right? Is the sequence I am having. 1, 2, minus 1. And I'll try to mark 0 index with some marking, arrow kind of thing. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, minus 1 is my sequence. And first one is 0, right? This corresponds to 0. I'll try to mark this with arrow. Marking this one with arrow means this will be x of 0, this will be x of 1, this will be x of 2. If something is there this side, before this marking, then that will be x of minus 1, after that x of minus 2 and so on. Like that you can feel. This is my x of 0, this is my x of 1, this is my x of 2. This is some standard notation. X of 0, x of 1, x of 2. Similarly, can someone tell me what is my h of n? Yeah, what is my h of n? This is h of n, right? Yeah, you should answer. What is h of n?
1, 2.
1, 2, right? 1 comma 2. This is a sequence, right? Sequence of samples with an arrow at 1. This means this is equal to h of 0. Next one will be h of 1. Here there are some compact notations we are going to follow. This input sequence is an impulse response sequence. And what is my output then? V of n equals to. Yeah, you can have a look into this. This is straightforward, right? Output will be 1, 4, 3
minus
2. Arrow will be at 1. Because this corresponds to y of 0, right? Y of 0 into delta of n plus y of 1 into delta of n minus 1 and so on. This is y of 0, right? Y of 1, y of 2, y of 3. Yes. Can someone answer? Okay, is there any observation here? Do you found any observation? Let me have lower index with L1, okay, or Lx, the lower index, the upper index denoted by Ux. Index, this corresponds to index. And lower index for this one is Lh, upper index for this one is Uh, upper index. Index means that n equal to 1, something is there, right? These are the indices, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, these are the indices. And let me represent this one with Ly. Let me represent this with the upper index, right? Uy. Ly equal to 0 here. Uy equal to, what is Uy here?
3, sir.
3, right? It's an index. I am looking for index. See, y of 3, right? Y of 1, y of 2, y of 3. Uy equal to 3. And ux equal to 2. Lx equal to 0. X of 0, right? Index is 0. This is 2. And Lh equals to 0, h of 0, right? Uh equals to 1, this is h of 1. Are you finding, can you have some observation over this? What's happening here? I have Lx equal to 0, Ux equals to 2. And I have Lh equal to 0. Uh equal to 1. Finally, I ended up with this one. Ly equal to 0 and Uy equals to 3. Uy equal to 3. Yeah. Any findings from this?
Lx plus Ly equals to Ly.
Yes, it's true. What's happening is they are getting added up. What's actually happening here is, after doing linear convolution, we are going to get something like this. ux plus uh equals to uy. Like that we are getting after doing linear convolution. That's what we are going to expect. Then what is the length of this output sequence? How to find the length of this sequence? Length is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 is the length of the sequence. Length is 4. Then how to find length of y? Is it true or false? I am claiming that uy minus ly. Is it true or false? There is some adjustment you need to do. Yeah, is it true or false?
False, sir.
Uy minus ly is 3, right? 3 minus 0 is 3. We need to add plus 1 to this. Uy minus ly plus 1. Similarly, if you want to find the length of this one, the indices are 2, right? 2 minus 0 is 2, but length is 3. 1, 2, 3, right? Plus 1 you need to add. Similarly, here also, length is 2. If you simply subtract this index and this index, 1 minus 0, we'll get 1. We need to add plus 1 to that after subtraction. Now, what is the length of this output sequence? Let me say that. Length of x and length of y, ln gdh of h. Length of h here is 2. Length of x here is 3, right? Then what is length of y we got? Length of y equals to? We got length of y as 4, right? 4. The length of y is 4. Yeah, how to proceed now? With any relation?
Length of x plus length of h minus 1.
Yes, that is true as well. Length of y equals to length of x plus length of y equals to length of x plus length of h minus 1. It's valid as well. It's true. See, the reason is you can have like this also. Let me go with this. Length of y is nothing but uy minus ly plus 1, right? According to that earlier theory, upper limit minus lower limit plus 1. And uy is nothing but ux plus uh, right? Uy. Ly is nothing but lx plus lh plus 1. Then ux minus lx plus uh minus lh plus 1. Okay, what is this? Uh minus lh plus 1. Length of h, right? Again, have a look into this. Length of h equals to length of h equals to, this is uh, this is lh, uh minus lh is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, right? That's the length of this one. This is length of h. What about this? If you add plus 1 to this, then that will be length. What we are going to do is, we will try to add 1 and subtract 1, plus 1 and minus 1, do minus 1. Then this part corresponds to
length of x.
Length of x, right? It means we are going to get length of x plus length of h minus 1. Is minus 1 left over, right? Minus 1. This is after convolution. If you do convolution of x, linear convolution of x with h, the final length we are going to get is the length of x, length of h summation and minus 1. Now, is it expanding or contracting after convolution? In this case, we have length of x is 3, length of h is 2, length of y after linear convolution, we are going to get like, see, I am avoiding index n. You can have that. There is no issue with that. L of x plus L of y minus 1. 3 plus 2 minus 1. That equal to 4. It's expanding, right? You can try to have a look into this one. This is my h. 1 or 2 samples, right? 2 non-zero samples consecutive. And this is my x. 1 or 2 non-zero, 3 non-zero consecutive. When coming to y, that got expanded, right? I have 4 samples, right? Non-zero samples. It's trying to expand, right? Due to that memory property of the system. There is some memory property of the system. You can think about that after going back. Yeah. Okay, it's already more than enough. Let me stop recording.